are here at the Sheridan Complex with CC Coletti Band today. Mr. Jim Sheridan's hosting a concert series through these months on his property. And I'd like to introduce everybody to CC and TJ of CC Coletti Band. We are good. How are you? Welcome to AMP-TV today.
Yeah, very good.
We're so excited about kicking off this new platform in 2021. So you're going to be one of the first content pieces on there. We're really excited about
Fantastic. Thank you for having us.
Absolutely. So tell us about CC Coletti Band. How did you get started? And some of the music, the way you approach your music.
Sure. Well, I started out, singing with my family around holidays and that sort of thing. My brother played the guitar after Thanksgiving dinner. We would sit around, and one day I said to my brother, let's start a band. So we got some songs put together. We got a few gigs under our belt and started at 19 years old. I did mostly covers at first. And then I was lucky to come in contact with a couple artists musicians that were playing with Meatloaf in Hunterdon County. So I ended up getting a job with Meatloaf as a backup singer, and toured with him for 7 years, and then met a producer friend, Anthony Krizan, wrote 2-3 albums at that studio with him. And we're just making music. We're making music, having fun, enjoying life. And this crazy year, 2020, things are altering and changing, and I'm looking forward to creating new, fresh music.
Absolutely.
Once I was driving blind, I couldn't read the signs, searching for guiding light to follow. I'm leaving it all behind. There's peace in my soul, peace in my mind, peace in my heart. I'll never grow. Shook off the
days. Did you also grow up in a musical family?
No. My cousins were musically inclined. Happened to be my parents, and my brother's younger than me, so he wasn't. Started around, I'm not even sure, 14, 15, maybe a little bit late, and got rocking and rolling and playing with my cousin and some of his friends, and just one band after another, and then led to record label stuff and doing that and out on the road playing. And as CC said, you meet a lot of people, so once you're in that clique, then you go from band to band. And after half a dozen years or so, I just needed to stop for a little bit. Wasn't sure for how long, and then I met CC. So about 6 months out of what felt like an eternity of playing out on the road and everything. We started an acoustic electric, and then it went from this to that to a truck to trailers to to touring and a lot of good stuff, and here we are today. So we just rock and roll and have a great time doing it, and we play a lot, and it's all good stuff.
My husband TJ is the jack of all trades. He's a farmer, so he pushes the band. He makes the band go forward. He does the equipment. We own all the equipment. He owns the truck and trailer. We practice at our farm studio, rehearsal studio. He plays bass. We call him MacGyver. He's the jack of all trades. Well,
somebody's got to do it, so I just happen to be there.
So without my husband, all these years of playing, man, it would have been difficult. And for standing by my side while I toured with Meatloaf for 7 years had to have been really tough. And,
Yeah, that's quite a testimony right there.
Yes.
It really is. I mean, the road, how'd you feel about that? What's it like?
Mayor.
Being on the road with Meatloaf and that kind of life, and enough was enough after a certain amount of years, like kind of you took a hiatus.
Yeah, I took a breather.
Yeah. Same thing.
It was honestly, I had to pinch myself. Especially when I first got there and I'm in London and I'm at the hotel and they knock on my door and they say, "Here's your bags and here's an envelope full of cash." I'm like, I didn't even do anything yet. I'm like, I just left a club in Branchburg, New Jersey, like a week ago, graduated from massage school, and here I am on tour with Meatloaf. It was, I swear, it was a dream. Meatloaf's the best. He texted me last night, just a heart, and said, "I love you."
So great.
Just a wonderful human being. And I'm lucky and I'm blessed that I was able to perform with such an icon, and the family, the band, I mean, the Patty Russo, Paul Crook, Kazem Sultan, John Michelli, Mark Alexander, and then all the other additional musicians that I met, and the people, and the memories, and where it brought me from playing in a bar to playing Wembley Stadium twice.
That's when you feel it's surrealistic, and how did this bag of money show up in my hand? I get you.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's
like a movie.
Crazy. At that point, I was with Meatloaf. I never even wrote an original song at that point. So I was in a cover band. So it's been an interesting road for me and my husband.
Amazing. Thank you for the background information.
Yeah.
On that. Yeah.
Sure.
Amazing stories.
Many others who would beg, steal, and lie. to inject you, seduce you and affect you, like the way I do. Oh, nobody loves you like the way I do. Nobody wants you like the way I do. Nobody needs you like the way I do. Nobody aches just to hold you.
So what is CC Coletti Band doing now? How has it been in this sort of virtual situation during the pandemic?
It's been a little crazy, a little interesting. It was in a sense a little bit of a blessing in disguise, because we took a break from our guitar player, Anthony. No problems, you know, mutual. We just floated our separate ways, and after 16 years of playing, so it was actually really good, because it happened at a perfect time where we could just sort of, without the pressure and all the gigs on our plate, sort of figure out where we wanted to go. And we started up again in the beginning of the summer, you know, when everyone started feeling comfortable even getting together. We started playing with an amazingly talented fellow young gentleman, Joe Cerati, who you will see performing with us today. The dude, he's so humble. What do I say? He's effortless. His playing is effortless. He's so humble. He's just the nicest guy in the world. You know, doesn't have a, hey, I played with Meatloaf or whatever, but hey, I got lucky, you know? He's unbelievable. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see you walking through the clouds. Circus minds, he's running wild. A fast and zebras and moonbeams and fairy tales. Plus he thinks of all, he's riding with the wind. When I'm sad, well, she comes to me. A thousand smiles, she gives to me free. It's all right, she said, it's all right. You're taking the thing you want from me. Thank you.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Thursday, Sunday, Saturday, blah, blah, blah. It was kind of nice. We have a 7-year-old. It was nice to just sort of regroup. You know, when you're going and going and going and going, you're constantly just playing the same songs and your covers and originals, and, you know, you get stuck in a rut. And I'm sort of feeling like I want to refresh, hit that refresh button like a lot of people have done. And I'm looking forward to almost taking a break again, and like at the end of this month, and starting to write some new tunes with Joe and whoever else wants to write songs with me.
Is that some of the stuff you're going to be playing today? Some originals and some cover songs?
Definitely. Yeah. We're going to play some originals, some of the songs that are on my two albums that I'm so proud of. I think it's the best thing. Woodstock Lane is my first solo album, and it's the street I grew up on in Branchburg, New Jersey. So, you know, I'm the youngest of five in a big musical family. And then my second album is Let It All Hang Out. We ended up doing a festival at Waterloo called Let It All Hang Out. I have some Christmas original songs. We're definitely going to play, you know, like I said, it's great because we're, you know, slowly the train's like getting back on the tracks with Joe, and, you know, I'm giving him some songs, but I don't want to just get stuck in that rut again. You know, I want to move forward. I want to start something fresh.
I think a lot of people can appreciate the fact that we all had to take a pause and get to connect with family a little deeper some level, and friends a little deeper some level. Those people that needed support, we could offer that if we felt we had the strength during the pandemic and really help out people. And then, yeah, it's been a while, so you want to get the train gears rolling again, and this is a great day. Where people are thrilled to have you here and see you guys performing live. Have you been doing some streaming for your fans?
Yes, we have.
What
we did, we
also did streaming.
Well,
he sets that up.
I set the platform
he
for the streaming.
He built a stage on our 10.5-acre farm.
So I've been gathering some wood for the last few years. I was going to build another outbuilding or add to one. And as soon as we heard this pandemic situation was coming around, I had said to Cece, I said, maybe I should build the stage out off the back of the studio, because there's nowhere to play unless they keep saying if you play outside and you're in open air and the people are dispersed somewhat, that you'll be pretty good off. So I built the stage, it's about 30 by 8, and we have full lights and electric and Wi-Fi and everything. It's already been out there. So we play to, I don't know, we play to about 6 acres. So the people that we invite, it's just not open to the public. We just can't go that far. But the people that we invite, they respond. They bring their little tents and their blankets and their seats, and they can pretty much roam over 6 of the almost 11 acres, and they can sit wherever they want. And we live pretty rural, so we don't have a problem with any of that. And it seems everyone enjoys themselves. And when we're streaming live to the world, we usually get 6,000, 7,000 views a show, so it's pretty good. And we have a lot of fun, so there's plenty of room. There's a lot more room for a lot more people, but it's been comfortable the way we've been doing it.
You guys are playing it safe and still serving your fans, still having some fun.
Exactly.
Oh, fantastic. Is this your music?
I don't have my phone, darling. This is Caden, our 7-year-old son.
We're going to be on TV. Look at that.
He wants to be a YouTube star.
Caden, are you also a musical? Do you sing? Do you dance? Do you play? Do you farm? Tell us what you do.
Come on, don't be.
I hear a little singer voice in there. Do you sing a little bit?
Dada, with like outside.
Yeah, well, that's outstanding. Yeah, I'm sure he needs help with those acres out there. Yes, yeah,
he sings constantly.
Well, he was on stage with us. We did a few songs by AC/DC one of our shows, and he came up and helped sing TNT.
Yep,
Mommy and Daddy.
Yes. First vocal background vocal job. Yes. He did. Yes. TNT.
This is truly a family moment. We are absolutely loving this. It's all about family. This is great. Anything you want to tell your fans before we go, or anything you want to talk about that's coming up?
We, like I said, looking forward to writing some new music, and keep your eyes peeled. CCColletti.com.
Stop that.
It's okay. The whole world is weird right now. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, just keep your eyes peeled for us, and I'm looking forward. I don't even know what's gonna come out of me with some new music and some of the new people that I'm gonna be writing with. So I'm actually really looking forward to that and seeing where it sort of takes me. I've been like in a rock and roll stage, and you know, I'm a little bit of country and a little bit of rock and roll. So.
And that note, we wish you guys a great show today. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
It's a funky blues rock and roll song. Come on. you. How about some Led Zeppelin? So I thrill her with every touch. I need to tell her she's the only one I really love. I got a woman gonna bow all day. I got a woman, she won't be true, no, no, no. When we go down to church, see the men folks standing in line. So don't they come to pray to the Lord, but my little girl looks so fine. Said in the evening when the sun is sinking low, everybody's with the one they love. I walk the town, keep on searching all around, looking for my street corner girl. Hey, hey, what can I do? I got a woman gonna fall. Hey, hey, what can I do? I got a woman, she won't be true, no, no. Hey, hey, what can I do? I got a woman, stay drunk all the time. Does a midnight shift, she flies around all of the town. I guess there's just one thing left for me to do. Gonna pack my bags and move on my way. Cause I got a worried mind, she would wanna know it's mine. Gonna leave her where the guitar's playing. Yeah, hey, hey, what can I do? I got a woman, she won't be true, no. Hey, hey, what can I do?
Hey, hey, what can I do?
I got a woman, stay drunk all the time.
Hey, hey, what can I do? silent. He can't make up his mind. No, yeah, no, yeah, no. Oh, such fun. Place you go, yes, you can penetrate any place you go. I told you so. All I want is you. Everything has got to be just like you want it to. Everything you want. Oh, now I roll a song, well, you can imitate everyone you know. You can imitate everyone you know. I told you so. Year. Crazy year. Thanks for coming to the Highway Pub, everybody. Sit back, relax, look at this, we're outside. It's November 8th, my sister's birthday. Happy birthday, Christine. Yeah. We got here, we're like, should we play inside? Should I stay or should I go? What should we do? And we're like, really? Is there really any decision making happening here? We picked the right spot for today. Thank you. Let's get loud and crazy. 5, 6. I want you. I want you so bad. I want you. I I want you so bad. It's driving me mad. It's driving me mad. I want you. I want you so badly. I want you. I want you so bad. It's driving me mad. It's driving me mad. I want you, I want you so badly. I want you, I want you so bad. It's driving me mad, it's driving me mad. I want you so bad. That's one of my favorite Beatles songs.
Trouble,
you're my angel.
Trouble.
You're my angel.
Trouble.
Okay. All right. This next song is in a. How we doing? I can't hear you.
Hey, baby. Hi, baby love. What you doing?
This next song is an original song of mine. It's called "You Were My Angel."
Oh, I love that song.
Oh. Y'all, you are my angel, sweetheart. You're my blossom angel. That's what I call you. Me. You're so sweet. This is my blossom angel. But this song was written about my mom and dad, and it's called "You Were My Angel." Because, you know, your mom's always there. She's trying to tell you what to do, and she's telling you, you know, you should do this. And get Carolyn, Michelle, Coletti. Get your butt over here. And, you know, at the time, you don't think that she's an angel. She's a pain in your butt, you know. But then when, you know, I lost my mom and my dad at a young age. They were way too young of cancer. And you look back, you're like, wow, they really were my angels. And they're still my angels, and they're always there with me every day. And I got my blossom angel now. And everybody's got an angel. And this is "You Were My Angel," and I hope you guys dig it. Everything changed in the blink of an eye, and I only wish there was time to say goodbye. Since you've been gone, I spent my days chasing fading away. You were my angel. You were my flame. You were my in my name. I long for your touch. I still see your smile, and I feel your presence, and I keep reading the showed me the light, and I lost my way. I still hear you say, you are my angel. Mama, I remember the words you used to say. I'll go.
Thank you so much. Blossom Angel, thank you so much.
Mommy.
What, buddy?
Remember in games, like you had 16?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's like Gudadama or G, they make GP.
You're kidding me.
It's not XP, it's
GP. I can't even, I don't even believe it, dude. Wait, that's far out.
Mama, look.
Whoa, you're right.
Look, they were like, it's Gudadama, so.
That's what I'm talking about, carefree.
We have one more song, honey, and we're going off.
We're gonna play a song called Trouble With Me. What's the trouble with you? No. Woo! I got all my biker friends together and we did a video. It was a while ago. It's time for new music. That was one of the funnest days of my life. Well, come on, Kimmy. You know you were dancing on the bar last night. I bet you Dorinda and Jimmy were. Right? Woo!
I was dancing on the bar last night. My skirt was short and a little too tight. I woke up this morning on the cover of A Girl's Gone Wild. I was riding with this dude named Brad. Here comes trouble. Must have been all of that whiskey I had. Well, I guess I should have stopped. Thank you.
to take a real short break. Thank you very much for CC. I'm CC Coletti. This is Joe Cerati. This is TJ Jablonski. And I love you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Welcome to Amp TV. We are here with the owner of the Highway Pub Series, the concert venue that we're at today for CC Coletti Band. And this is Mr. Sheridan. Mr. Sheridan, thank you so much for joining us today on Amp TV. Tell us a little bit about how the Highway Pub Series or the music venue got started.
Well, I'll give you a quick lowdown on this. I was 13 years old, started playing professional guitar. I quit when I married my wife in 1975, which was a long run of making money playing my guitar. Love music. I made a lot of money with it. Helped me buy my first house and all. Then I owned a corporation for a while. Got away from music. We built this house, and prior to building this house in New Jersey, we used to hold gatherings. We had music gatherings here. But when I built this house, it was a custom home that we built. One of my dreams was to build a pub-like situation where it was enough to accommodate about 50 people. And knowing a lot of musicians in the area, I would invite groups over to play their music here, right on this stage, for 50 people out there to enjoy it. It's wonderful that people actually do want to hear live music. And, you know, we did this for not only ourselves, but for the music community. So that these young people that have bands and are trying to make money at it, me making money in my earlier days, I never made money with my guitar since I quit in 1975. I just want to give it back to the music community. And guys like James that does productions, and what I do is just promote music and live music and talents that people have in this business. We've had young groups here. I love to see the young people. Serene Green, they do bluegrass music. They won all sorts of awards in America for that. They have a Fig for a Kiss. We're supposed to do the St. Patrick's Day thing here, but COVID kind of nixed that. So this is the first one since COVID that we have an outside venue. Normally it's all inside here with people inside having a good time. So thank you for coming, and thank you for having me with you guys today.
Absolutely. Thank you, Jim. The first show that you ever had at the venue, was that January, or did you start before that?
We started in January of 2018. The pub was done. We were only in here less than 6 months, and this pub was done. The first group is the gentleman that made this bar. His name is Mark Spellman. He's from Ireland, and the name of the group is Without George. They do Irish music. They do all original music. They do some covers, but for the most part, they occupied the stage here in January. That was the first gig we ever had here. And these gentlemen are here today. They're here from Ireland. They're here at this venue. And Mark and Johnny Holleran, Mark Spellman, were the first group here to ever play. And it was a hit.
To break the ice, yeah. Well, Jim, I know that the community that came out today absolutely loved this. I know that you're doing great things for your community, bringing them together and unifying people. Music unifies people, brings families together. So we thank you, and we're honored to be here. Thank you.
Well, thank you, James, and thank you very much for having me interviewed here, and thanks for coming.
A pleasure.
The CC Coletti Band is a wonderful group. Did you know that she toured with Meatloaf?
Yeah, you know, we had a chance to talk a little bit about that in her interview.
Yeah. So she's quite talented, and she's her name to fame is Janis Joplin when she does Janis Joplin.
Yeah, we saw a little bit about that today, and we'll see some more on Amp TV when we take a look at the concert later. Thanks again.
Thank you again. Thank you.
Coming back for more.
whiskey in my hand, sugar in the kitchen, could have seen my back door man, flat high on the moonshine, soaking in some red wine. Oh baby, you taste fine. Behind just might be too much. Reach a man, I can hardly breathe. Understand my need. I found a love that's gonna set me free, take me home, oh yeah. On my CD that we have for sale up here. It's called Barnyard. Okay, here's a song called Girls Like Me. Coming up, and I'm going.
the beer. I got a champagne test on a Bush Light budget. I'm spending all of your money and you might get lucky. I'm easy to love, but I'm harder to please. Here's a song from Susan Tedeschi. Dennis, Caden's new buddy. Touch me.
I'm missing you. Hey, baby. So thank you very much. All right. Here's a tune from Bill Withers. thank you.
Great song.